Hello everyone, today we'll be starting with the first stage of tooth development, which is the bud stage. Here, first of all, let us see what is tooth germ. Because tooth germ is the component which gives rise to complete tooth. So what is it? Tooth germ is the primordia for developing tooth. Now it has two components. One is the ectodermal component and the other is the mesenchymal component. Okay, so from the ectodermal component, what is formed is the enamel organ, and from the mesenchymal component, two components are formed. One is the dental sac or follicle, and other is dental papilla. Okay, so this is what these are what the components of tooth germ. One is ectodermal, one is mesenchymal. Ectodermal gives rise to enamel organ. Mesenchymal gives rise to two components. One is dental sac and the other is dental papilla. Now let us see what are the changes that occur in the bud stage of the tooth development. So here, first of all, let us see what is enamel organ. See, enamel organ, it is originated from the oral ectoderm. ठीक है, oral ectoderm से आया क्या? Dental lamina, and उससे proliferate होके बना है enamel organ. ठीक है, enamel organ में क्या होते हैं? दो type of cells होते हैं. One is the peripheral low columnar cells or the basal columnar cells. These are the peripheral cells. And other is the polygonal cells, okay? They are the centrally located cells. So peripheral columnar cells and the centrally located polygonal cells. This basal cells, they are continuous with the oral epithelium, okay? So these basal cells, they are continuous with the oral epithelium. Now these two cells, they together form the enamel organ. Now what is the fate of enamel organ? It in future gives rise to enamel. Okay, so this is the enamel organ. Now the epithelium, it is separated by this epithelium. It is separated by the underlying mesenchyme by a basement membrane. See, this is the basement membrane which is separating the epithelium with the underlying mesenchyme. Now there is the mitotic activity and the ectomesenchymal condensation which is surrounding the tooth. Ectomesenchymal condensation plus यहाँ पे और क्या होता है? Mitotic activity. So this forms what? This forms the dental papilla. Okay, so this is the dental papilla. Now the dental papilla, it gives rise to pulp and dentine. So enamel organ gives rise to enamel, dental papilla gives rise to pulp and dentine. Now those mitotic activity and the ectomesenchymal condensation which is surrounding both enamel organ and dental papilla. Okay, so it is surrounding what? Dental papilla also and enamel organ also. That is known as dental sac. Dental sac, it gives rise to three things. One is cementum. Then PDL. Then part of alveolar socket. Okay, so this is how the Various structures are formed from the tooth germ, and this is how it proliferates. So it is divided into three parts: enamel organ, dental papilla, and dental sac. The enamel organ consists of basal columnar cells and the central polygonal cells. Okay, so it gives rise to enamel. Then the enamel organ is separated by a basement membrane. It separates the mesenchyme and the enamel organ. After the enamel organ, surrounding it, there is a mitotic activity in ectomesenchymal condensation taking place, which is known as dental papilla. It gives rise to pulp and dentine. Surrounding the dental papilla and enamel organ, again there is ectomesenchymal condensation, which is known as dental sac, and it gives rise to cementum, PDL, and the some part of alveolar socket. So these are the changes only that take place in the bud stage. What happens is, from the oral ectoderm, a bud-like growth is taking place. Okay, oral ectoderm se ek bud-like growth ho rahi hai is stage mein. Thank you. Keep visiting.